Good evening, everyone. It is so fun to see everybody here and actually see some faces out there. Even though they're half masked, it is okay. We are happy you are here. We are happy to celebrate face to face with you. Welcome students and families to Beat the Odds 2021. A special welcome to our Tempe Union High School District Governing Board members, to our executive team. Thank you so much for being here with us tonight. We appreciate you. We appreciate that you take the time to support Beat the Odds and come out and honor our students every year. We have had quite the year. It has been a struggle, and it has been full of resilience and perseverance. It's been full of some wins and some losses, but in the end, we are just so thrilled to be able to honor the students that are here with us tonight, who've persevered and who have really truly beat the odds in so many ways. We, at Beat the Odds every year, I talk about how we are not here to celebrate teen pregnancy, but we are here to celebrate the resilience and the perseverance and the tenacity it takes to truly beat the statistical odds and to walk across the stage as a graduate, which so many students in these young people's shoes may not do. These students have made the choice to work hard, to rise above, and to set a goal and to accomplish it. We are just so proud of you. Every year, I write a little speech and I'm just super inspired and proud of our students. This year, I have to say, it was just so different. I was writing this out and I was thinking, there's some students that I met face to face for the first time tonight because they've done all their work online. There are some students that I've only seen come in and out because they've been working online and have committed to that. So it has been a challenging year, but it's also a really special year to celebrate. And so I am just thrilled that we are able to be here tonight to honor each one of our graduates and to celebrate all that it took for them to beat the odds. So thank you for coming. Thank you for joining us. A few just little housekeeping things, just to keep everybody safe. Keep your masks on when you are not eating or drinking. Graduates, when you come up onto the stage, you'll wear your mask, and then we can take those off for a quick picture with families if you want. If you need the bathrooms and you haven't found those already, you probably have, though, because you have babies. They are just directly in the back of the room right there. With that, I would like to welcome Ms. Doris Sampson, the principal of Compadre, to the stage.
Well, I'd like to echo what Ms. Carmody said. We haven't had this many people in our cafeteria in a year and a half. So this is amazing. It's so nice to see you all and to see your faces. I can't even begin to tell you how exciting that is for all of us to see you. And like Ms. Carmody said, it's been virtual. We've been staying in touch virtually, but to see you in person really, really means a lot. And it is my great honor to speak tonight at this wonderful occasion because it is a celebration of you. And I'd like to welcome the governing board, the executive team, teachers, families, friends, and students tonight. Well, what matters most to children is what their parents do. When parents raise their children in nurturing, warm, sensitive, and responsible ways, children grow and flourish. You are their first and most important role model. If you're cooking, they want to help. If you're at the computer, and you all know this, they want to touch the keys. If you're on the phone, oh, they love that, they want to look at the pictures of themselves. They'll probably change a few settings on your phone, too. Finishing school is one of the most important things you can do for yourself and for your child. They see you tonight, and they will see you next week in your cap and gown, and they'll want to be just like you, a graduate from high school. There's an old saying, Actions speak louder than words. Your actions tonight say volumes to your child, to your parents, to your family, and to all of us. You have persevered and you are resilient. You are a role model. I love to quote Dr. Seuss. You have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself in any direction you choose. You chose graduation. Congratulations on your success. I'd like to introduce our student speaker, Aureli Salgado Juarez.
Good evening, and thank you all for coming. This pandemic has sure been tough, right? I know we are all hoping to bring everybody who supported us to beat the odds, but please know that we are grateful for the opportunity to celebrate in person with three of our supporters. My name is Aureli Salgado, and I am a 21-year-old mother of two beautiful daughters, Isabella and Giselle. I found out I was pregnant at 17. I was 2 months into my pregnancy, I was not attending school at the time. I was a senior and a high school dropout. After Isabella was born, I began to think about how I didn't graduate. My niece Herexi was attending Compadre and part of the TAPP program. She was in her last year of getting ready to graduate. It got me thinking about actually going back and finishing school. I had been out of school for 3 or 4 years. I knew it wasn't going to be easy, but I also knew I had the motivation of my daughter and the drive and ability to do. After thinking about returning to school for a few weeks, I approached my boyfriend and my mom. They both supported me and encouraged me to do it. My first day back on campus was September 5th. I remember that day because it was my birthday. To me, without a doubt, it was awesome. I started on my birthday as it meant new beginning and a new year. Being 20 years and older than most of my classmates was difficult, but I wasn't going to let any drama or anyone stop me. When I was younger and in high school, I always thought everything was hard. I thought the teachers just hated me and gave me bad grades. But now I know that it was me the whole time. I wasn't trying. This time around, I was not playing around. It was hard every day, but I had to keep going because I just kept thinking to myself, I need to graduate. Then the pandemic hit. I was pregnant with my second daughter. This pregnancy I found out at 2 weeks instead of 2 months. Completing the school year of 2020 wasn't difficult for me because I had all A's and had just to maintain them for the last 9 weeks. I have to admit though, this year was hard. I struggled to stay motivated. It might look like we were at home doing your work, but some kids didn't have to get out of bed. Those of us who were moms and dads had the extra distraction and responsibility of being a parent. I admit, not having to get both kids ready and driving 30 minutes 5 days a week was great. But I had a 2-year-old and a newborn wasn't easy. I was lucky I had my boyfriend to help me with the girls, but also there are mommy's girls, so it was really hard. It was difficult to stay focused on my work, but I think all my teachers that knew my situation were really understanding. Thank you. Lastly, I would like to thank those who helped me get to this proud moment and graduate. I would love to thank my TAPP teachers and Early Head Start and also Tracy because they welcomed me and my daughter Isabella since day one. Early Head Start has reached out during COVID. They have provided activities for Isabella and have helped with any resources that we were in need. I also like to thank my Young Lives mentor, Emily, and all of my Young Lives mentors for supporting us in every way, especially during this rough year. I am proud to say I endured this pandemic, high school, and all that life threw at us this year. I, Areli Salgado, beat the odds, and I'm a high school graduate.
Okay, well, we're done. We can go home. can't say much more than that. I have to tell you, when Areli, I remember the day that Areli came in to enroll, and she just hit the ground running, and just went hard the whole time, had A's across the board, and brought that little girl to school every day. She was nothing but consistent, so we're super proud of her. I want to move on and present our Zeta Johnson Scholarship. Let me find my page. Zeta is unable to be with us here tonight, but I know she's going to be watching online. The Zeta Johnson Scholarship is awarded annually to a pregnant or parenting teen in the Tempe Union High School District who plans to pursue post-secondary education. Zeta Johnson and her committee look over all the applicants who are required to submit essays, GPAs, as well as recommendation letters from a staff member or somebody that they are close to that can recommend them for the scholarship. Zeta has been a member of our Adolescent Pregnancy and Parenting Advisory Board, and she is such a great supporter of this program. I know she's so sad not to be here, but she was thrilled to be able to meet our scholarship recipient over Zoom. Last week we had a chance to chat, so I am very honored to present this year's Zeta Johnson Scholarship Award to Vianne Hernandez. While Vianne makes her way up to the stage, I will share with you that she shared her story of resilience during COVID and prior to that, and all that it took for her to get to graduation. Vianne is one of our wonderful students who attended class virtually all year with this little peanut at home with her. And all of us who are parents know just how challenging that is. As the winner of the Zeta Johnson Scholarship, Vianne wins $1,000 towards her education. She is also presented with the Tools for School Scholarship, which provides her a computer and the technology that she's going to need as she pursues her education at Mesa Community College. So a huge thank you to Zeta Johnson and to our East Valley Women's League, who are continual supporters of this program, and our graduates. Thank you very much, and congratulations, Vianne. This is Irony right here, running around and having lots of fun. They always love the stairs. It's always a thing, the stairs. So sorry, Vianne. So we're gonna move on now to our student recognition. This is our favorite part of the night. So if I could invite Ms. Whitmire up to the stage, Ms. Hodge, come on up to the stage. We are going to present our graduates with certificates. We graduates, I think I've caught most of you and explained how this is going to work. So I'm going to call your name, come on up this direction, and then come across the stage this way. When I call the name of the person in front of you, you have that list. You can be prepared to just follow that person up, okay? Members of the governing board, executive team, principals, if you want to congratulate graduates, you're welcome to line up at this time with Ms. Sampson and Mr. Hansen, and give them a fist bump as they head down the stage. We also have some graduates from Mountain Point and some graduates from Marcos, so you are also welcome to go congratulate your graduates. Our first graduate tonight is Nayeli Avila Reyes. See, this is my favorite part. I get goosebumps every time. The first name, every time I get goosebumps. Nayeli joined us from McClintock High School nearly 2 years ago and had baby Lucas in January 2020. Lucas is a thriving, busy one-year-old who spent his first year in the TAPP Infant Care Childcare and is now part of the Open Horizons program, which enables him to have childcare in the community while Nayeli worked towards the goal of graduating on time. Nayeli's motivation is her parents because they came to this country for a better life. She has already started her own very successful side business and is striving towards either enlisting in the Army post-graduation or attending community college. Congratulations, Nayeli. Moises Carvajal Milan. I think he and baby look a lot alike, I'm just gonna say, like, so much. Moises became involved with TAPP this past semester. Moises is an amazing dad. He works full-time and has worked hard to finish school. He recently received the Committed Award from the Counseling Department at this week's Compadre Award Ceremony. Moises has remained committed to his classes and to be a May graduate, and we are so proud to see he and Mateo walk across the stage tonight. Congratulations, Moises. Navea Flores. Navea is new to TAPP, however, she is a steadfast Compadre student, enjoying all Compadre has had to offer since her freshman year. Navea is due in October and is excited to have graduated before she has baby Ramos. Navea was most motivated to graduate when her family came in to meet with her counselor and she saw graduation was within reach. She was determined, she turned over a new leaf this year, and she has been amazing. Navea received an award at Compadre's PAC Awards Night and has become a student teachers can absolutely count on. Navea is prepared to gain full-time work after graduation. Congratulations, Navea. Aspen Grant. Joined Compadre and the TAPP program a year and a half ago with baby Eliana, who at the time was just 3 months old. Aspen commuted, wait for it, from Surprise daily in an effort to complete her graduation requirements alongside Eliana, who was enrolled in the infant room. Aspen actually completed her required graduation credits for graduation in December while working and caring for Eliana at home. Aspen credits her parents, her daughter, TAPP staff, and her amazing Compadre teachers with supporting her and continuing to motivate her to get her high school diploma. Congratulations, Aspen. Jackie Guillen. Jacqueline joined Compadre from her homeschool McClintock when she was pregnant with Fernando, who we all learned to call Fernie. That's our nickname for him anyway. Fernando was one of our littlest Lobos, starting in the infant room at 2 weeks old after Jackie's maternity leave. And then he moved on to early Head Start, where he did amazing. Jackie is enrolled with the Arizona at Work program and plans to complete her certificate to become a pharmacy technician. Jacqueline knows pursuing her goal of pharmacy tech will be a transition because, like many, she has been home for a year completing virtual learning with her 2.5-year-old Fernie by her side. Jackie. Congratulations, Jackie. Miss Denise Harper. We have not seen Denise for a little while because she graduated in December and only had a credit left, so it is amazing to see her and baby Audrey here tonight. Denise completed her first 3 years of high school at Tempe High, and her senior year she joined the TAPP and Compadre family. Denise had baby Audrey in fall, and Audrey attended school with Denise until COVID began. Denise was one of the three TAPP graduates who completed their required credits in December, and she plans to continue working now that she's graduated. Congratulations, Denise. Vianne Hernandez. Vianne is mama to Renny Rose, who is a busy and healthy two-year-old. For Vianne, transportation was a huge barrier, so she utilized Tempe Union's virtual learning option starting in fall of 2020. Vianne adjusted to a new school, online learning, and caring for her baby full-time while attending class at home. It's just incredible. She took an extra class this semester to be able to graduate on time. Like I mentioned before, her goal is to attend Mesa Community College, where she's already enrolled, and pursue the vet tech program. Congratulations, Vianne. Nicolette Martinez. Nicolette, this girl, I feel like I've known this girl for a long time. I tell you what, Nicolette came to us pregnant, and then she left for a little bit because life just didn't allow her to attend school. And then when she came back, we were thrilled, and she's just been on a roll ever since. She had Hartley in the infant room for a little bit, and then she moved on to Early Head Start. Nicolette has worked super hard to make up her credits, especially those in math. I'm sorry, math teachers, you are not her favorite. But she did it, she got through it. Nicolette plans to work for a year after graduation and is considering a career in cosmetology. Congratulations, Nicolette. Aureli Salgado Juarez. We can all watch her try to get up here with two girls. You can just only one? Oh, bring them both. Aureli is the mother of these two sweet girls, three-year-old Isabella and 10-month-old Giselle. Aureli returned to school, like she said, as a very mature student. She came back knowing that graduation was the key to her success, and she never quit in her goal to earn that high school diploma. Aureli completed her credits in December of 2020, attending virtually while managing these two little girls at home. I keep saying they're gonna have the stories to tell about doing school online with babies on their laps that the rest of us are gonna talk about teaching with kids around us. They're gonna be students. Aureli is still finalizing her post-graduation plans and is either gonna work at the culinary restaurant field or attend UTI to pursue a certification as an auto mechanic, where she's already been accepted. Congratulations, Aureli. Jessica Vargas Sanders. So we have seen a lot of Miss Jess this year because she has worked really, really hard to catch up on some credits. Jessica is a Mountain Point student who came to Compadre with that same need to catch up and graduate on time. Jessica is a motivated and hardworking student who set her mind on the goal of graduation, and let me tell you, she has let nothing stand in her way. Lilo, her daughter, is 10 months old and already walking. She's a go-getter, just like her mama. Lilo has been enrolled in the infant room this year while Jess worked to complete her classes and extra credits needed for graduation. Jess says she's motivated by her daughter Lilo and her mom because she wants to make them proud. Jess is the first one in her family to graduate. She plans to pursue post-secondary education at community college this year. Congratulations, Jess. All right, I'm gonna move out of Compadre and over to Marcos Deniza. Liliana Naranjo. Liliana is one of those students that I met for the first time tonight, but we've been Zoom meeting and texting and doing all those things to get her across the finish line. She is a graduate from Marcos Deniza and has worked extremely hard this year. She's due on May 28th, so that's coming real fast. We just need to hold on through graduation. We got another week. Liliana has completed Primavera courses, extra online courses, and has done a lot, making really solid plans to tick each box off. We are so proud of her. She is going to go on to South Mountain Community College this year. Daniel Rodriguez. Daniel is a Marcos Deniza graduate. He has grown throughout his high school career, balancing fatherhood, playing baseball for Marcos, schoolwork, and a part-time job. I have to tell you, we were at Marcos for open house, and I saw Daniel's big banner hanging there, and that was pretty cool to see. Daniel intends to work full-time after graduation to support his family. Daniel was motivated by his own little family and would like to thank his mom and dad who supported him throughout his journey these last 4 years. Congratulations, Daniel. Okay, we're going to move on to Mountain Point. Woohoo, Mountain Point! Paul Dunn. Paul is a Mountain Point student who is dad to Zaya. Zaya is, I think, walking in the door in a minute there. He is a happy and busy 2.5-year-old little man. Paul attended both virtually and in person this year, balancing parenting, work, and school. Oh, and here comes Zay. We gotta get the baby. That's what we all wanna see anyway, right? Everybody wants to see the baby. There he is! Paul is enlisted in the Army, correct, Paul? Yes, he's enlisted in the Army, and we are proud of his dedication to serve our country, and thank you for your future service. Congratulations, Paul. Oh, they want you that way, Paul. We have a couple students not here tonight that I want to recognize online, and then we have one more student that I will call up. Rebecca Ortiz Espinosa is not with us tonight. Her baby, Israel, was born on May 2nd, so she is a brand new mom. Becky is a compadre student who continues to work on her classes throughout her maternity leave to try to meet the requirements for graduation this year. Becky is a longtime compadre student who's well-loved by her teachers. She has participated in TAPP and the JAG program, and we are so thrilled to see Becky complete her requirements for graduation. Our final student not here tonight is Farhio Mohammed. I got to see her today, and unfortunately she could not get out of work tonight and out of work on graduation. So she chose graduation, which we're okay with. But Farhio came to us from McClintock in January of 2020 with this teeny tiny 4-pound baby that went into a childcare situation, and I got to see her today, and she is, you would never guess she was a preemie. She looks amazing. Farhio completed her credits this year online. She was doing virtual learning. She kept up with her classes in spite of having a really, really hard semester. Farhio plans to continue to go on to community college after graduation to pursue a degree as a certified ultrasound technician while she continues to work to support her family. I am so thrilled to announce our last graduate of the evening, Mackenzie Stewart. Mackenzie, go grab Zay from Paul. He gets 2 trips across. Go grab Zay. Mackenzie Stewart sought out TAPP her junior year in the fall of 2019. At the time, little Zaya was 5 months old, and Mackenzie knew she needed to find a school that would help her graduate. Zaya was enrolled in the infant room, and Mackenzie committed to attending Compadre, which, get this, included riding the city bus and the light rail over 2 hours each way to school. Mackenzie, this year, took 2 extra classes online in order to graduate on time, and she managed to finish those even though sometimes she said she didn't know if she could do it. Zaya is now 2 years old and has been attending community childcare with the help of the Open Horizons Scholarship Program with Tempe Community Council. Mackenzie is just a fantastic student, well-loved by her teachers. She also received the Courage Award from the City of Tempe this year, which is just an honor and tells you what kind of a person and student she is. Congratulations, Mackenzie. And with that, I am done talking. Thank goodness, you guys are getting tired of hearing my voice. We are gonna move on to staff recognition. I'm gonna invite Ms. Whitmeyer to come up and do that. Then we have a quick video for you to enjoy right after that.
Okay, I can tell everyone's getting restless, so I'm gonna try to be quick, but everyone who knows me knows I am the emotional wreck of the group next to Dora. Where's Dora? Yeah, I give you a run for your money. She only made it 11 minutes into the staff meeting this morning. That was a record, 11 minutes, and she was an absolute mess. So then, of course, I was an absolute mess. So it is, everybody has already said it, to be here in person is just a relief. It feels a little bit normal. Can't see your faces, so that's still a little creepy and weird. As you said when you came in, it's like a masquerade party we're all at. So that kind of gives it a little nicer light. Normally, I get to thank all of the outside of everyone who helps TAPP be TAPP. Volunteers, mentors, community partners, the list is endless of those that are kind of the, we call them the safety nets and the draft that helps keep us afloat. This year looked very different. We kind of looked within, so we couldn't have the outsiders coming in, and so we focused on what can we do to help serve while using some of the outside resources we have. So literally everyone in here in this room, you are partially responsible. Here, I'm gonna go. You are partially responsible for these graduates. And we appreciate everything you have done to help us make this evening happen and to get everyone here tonight to recognize you guys. Most importantly, of course, are the students. You guys did it. Couple of you, we had some rough bumps. We got a little nervous, but you always, I can see one of the mentors looking at one of the students going, yep, got to be tough. But that's part of it. You had a fork in your road and it just changed your plans. And you maintained, and I think Andrea said it best when she kept saying the perseverance, the determination, that's what gets you through. Teachers. I was already getting texts from you guys while I'm sitting over here of how much you're gonna miss this and being here and being a part of it for people that are all kind of moving to different places. You guys make me proud to have chosen such a worthy career. I've never been more proud to be a teacher than this year watching you guys. And I can say that for Mountain Point. I have a child at Mountain Point as well. I think as just in general in America, this year was so hard for you guys as students and so difficult, especially for people like me with a very old brain, trying to learn new technology, new platforms, new ways. How do you connect? How do you build the relationship? All of the struggles we all felt staring at a circle, trying to, can you turn your camera on just for a sec? Just want to see ya. I lucked out because the kids in this room that I had are amazing and they know that I have issues. So they would at least turn the camera on the baby. And I was good with that. I'm like, if I can just look at your baby for, I'm good. You know, and I got to see a puppy yesterday. It just, all cute things. So you guys remind us what it looks like. And I think Arelli did such a nice job of explaining how some kids during COVID stayed in bed. And you guys had to rise. You had babies, you had toddlers, you were trying to handle it. We fully understood. We said at multiple staff meetings, and we have the best teachers ever, that they would understand. You have to turn the camera off because you have a squealing little person that just wants all of your attention, and they want to be on the camera. So you guys showed us and showed, I think, yourselves how much more capable maybe you ever knew you could be. And you inspired us. Teachers, we noticed everything you did. We appreciate everything you did. We have teachers that, for example, Griffin with child development would step completely away from what a worksheet or what something looks like to say, you have a child. Here's what you can do with your baby, and just continues to help them and help us with parenting and nurturing and all things needed to be good parents. And each and every one of you are amazing parents. Admin, the same thing. We don't have words. You changed and helped us with transportation. You supported childcare opening, and as long as it was safe, and it's mind-blowing how much you care. When students are getting home visits from teachers and from a principal in a mask showing at your door saying, you aren't in school, what's going on? And the kids are like, Miss Sampson's at the door, I gotta go. And so it's wonderful to know that you're out there and you get it and you appreciate us and showed that. Thank you. Child care, oofta. I'm gonna use a couple people in here for examples. Even tonight, she's already raising her hand. We have one who came and said, ooh, I don't think my child's gonna do well. It's like, she just doesn't go to others. She doesn't really like to be with other people. And she walked in and within, I would say the first day, she is squealing with delight. She just reaches out to them. She said she got here tonight, and as soon as she saw childcare, it was like, mom, who? She went straight over to childcare. That loving completeness you give our babies, and we just watch their brains pop while they come in and out, is amazing. What a lot of you don't know is what else they did this year. They were doing home visits to surprise. They would drop anything we needed. If you needed a food box, it's there. If you need diapers, wipes, books, anything that was needed, childcare was there. Packing up the car, heading out. So a lot of people, I think, had this false, like, oh, teachers are sitting at home eating bonbons and childcare, well, there's nobody in there today. Oh, no. Then we're beating the path. I think Carmody and I spent about 6 hours one day on the road hitting houses. So thank you for your tireless efforts and for how much you love our littles. Andrea's gonna kill me, but thank you to Andrea. So she is tireless in how she works for your kids and for all of you to get childcare working, to get everybody where they need to be, and to keep us organized. That's a job, she has me, to keep organized and to keep on task is something. And Kelly, your social work skills are off the hook. There is not a rock you can't look under and find a resource to get to our kids, and we appreciate it. Our governing board, our executive team, our principals, all admin, you guys just, a thank you seems inadequate. You protected us, you kept us safe, you made some really hard decisions, you just got beat up in the media, on billboards, it was rough. And thank you for putting us first and for taking care of our littles and doing what needed to be done. Volunteers, East Valley Women's League, Young Lives, TAPP board and support staff. There's not a person that didn't move heaven and earth to help everyone in this room and to help the kids. And by everyone, I mean us. You came through when we needed you. I don't know if you guys saw, they had balloons and a table out front celebrating our graduates in, I don't know, it was probably 100 out today. So thank you. This video is always bittersweet for me because as I'm putting it together, my boys, my own kids at home, Fran and knows, they know me pretty well. They'll come down, mom's crying, she's working on the video, don't go in there. because they know when I'm putting the video together, I'm reliving all these moments with you in the classroom, in childcare, and I see Jackie and I just, my mind is blown at how you have just blossomed into this young woman from this girl we started with just a few years ago. So without further ado, I will start the video. Enjoy, and thanks for coming.
I'm gonna fill while you do that.
Well, Kim gets that started. Graduates, we're gonna watch the video, then we're gonna have some closing remarks. At the end of the ceremony, please come up over here. We have pictures for you and a few things over here for you, so please meet us up here before you leave for the evening. Thank you.
losing friends and I'm chasing sleep. Everybody's worried about me. In too deep, I say I'm in too deep. And it's been 2 years, I miss my home. But there's a fire burning in my bones. Still believe.
That was definitely some tears there. At this time, I'm going to invite Dr. Wilson to come up and give us some closing remarks. East Valley Women's League, I just want to confirm, what is on the table is for everybody to take home with them, correct? Okay, so I forgot to say that earlier. The bowls with all the snacks, those are yours to put in your pantry because I don't want them in my pantry. So go ahead and put them in your pantry. Take those home with you for your kiddos on the drive home. Thanks for coming tonight and welcome, Dr. Wilson.
Senior students, families, friends, staff, and special guests, I'm happy to be here this evening and honored to be here and proud of each and every one of you. Seniors, you are here because of your perseverance. Whether it was one special person in your life who helped you along the way to beat the odds, you are here today because of your determination to succeed and the faith and determination of others to make sure you found success. Although you may have overcome challenges during your time in high school and especially during this COVID-19 school year, you will still likely face some hurdles as you continue through life. Please do not forget to believe in yourself. Believe that you can achieve whatever goal you set your mind to do. You are the key element for success, and it will always start with you. Many caring and kind people have helped you get to where you are today, and many of whom are in this very room. Let's give them a round of applause. It's nice that you have honored and thanked them for being here for you. And it just may be a simple smile, a hand to hold, an ear to listen, but always remember the importance of giving back to others. All of you here tonight are a testament to the perseverance to meet your goal to graduate. You are in the final position to achieve this goal. Please take the time to appreciate all of your family members, your friends, your teachers, the staff, administrators who provided you with support, coupled with a warm smile to help you beat the odds. Again, congratulations, and I thank you, and it sounds like you all need to make sure you head over here to get your goodies. And am I right, they can take the things on the table as well. So congratulations, everyone.